Hello, everyone, and welcome to Jazz Therapy. This is Song Therapy. And today's Song Therapy is dedicated to how to have more love in your heart and to be more open-hearted and warm and loving. And I really wanted to just first start off by saying Happy Hanukkah to everyone who will be celebrating, since today is the first night of Hanukkah. And in that spirit of also having more love in our hearts and being more open, I also just really have been thinking about the continued war between Israel and Hamas and how we desperately need, as a world, as humanity, to have more love, tolerance, and acceptance for one another. If we had that, this conflict, this war would never have happened. I find myself seeing footage of what is happening in the war and feeling absolutely devastated to see pictures of mothers holding their children in body bags, to see all of Gaza annihilated, to read about hostages, Israeli hostages being released, and you know what they have had to endure. It's just been absolute horror all around, and yet I come back and remind myself that what I know I need to do to keep myself grounded is to try to be as open-hearted and as loving as possible. I deeply, deeply hope that there can be peace between Israel and Hamas. I understand Israel's need to want to defend itself, and also Palestine's need to have their own land. So I've just really been thinking about that, of how can we be more loving, how can we have more love in our lives on a grand scale, and also, you know, on a smaller level. So I'm going to be talking more about that today, but that's just kind of the gist of Song Therapy today, how to have more love in your life and in your heart. So let's just get to the music a little bit. So the song I have for you today is from American pianist and composer, legendary American pianist and composer, Dave Brubeck. And Dave Brubeck would have had a birthday this week on December 5th. He died in 2012 when he was 92. So I really got to do some exploration of his music, and I have not listened to as much Dave Brubeck as I have other artists, so it was wonderful to do a deep dive. I'll talk just a little bit about him, and then we'll get into the song. Dave Brubeck was born in Concord, California in 1920, and he started playing the piano. He did get drafted into World War II. However, he played at a Red Cross concert, and it was evidently a big hit, and so he did not go into combat. He played in the Army, band, and played piano, and you know, after he got out of the Army, then his career really took off. And he's really very widely known for having the best-selling jazz album of all time, which is the 1959 album, Time Out. And he's credited with being a big kind of jazz pop star. You know, jazz still, even in its heyday of popularity, was not as popular as like pop music and whatnot. And he really received a lot of attention for having just this big best-selling album. He went on to just have an incredibly wide-ranging career and played with so many greats and recorded in so many different styles of playing jazz and improvisation. And he also received myriad awards. He was a Kennedy Center honoree. President Obama gave him his award, and President Obama said, "You cannot understand America without understanding jazz, and you cannot understand jazz without understanding Dave Brubeck." So I really like that quote, and I wanted to share it with you. I especially just love the part about one cannot understand America without understanding jazz. I deeply resonate with that, President Obama. So let's get to the music. The song I have for you today is from a 1957 album entitled Dave Brubeck Plays and Plays. And the song I chose for you is the George Gershwin composition, Our Love is Here to Stay. Now, this album is really cool. Dave Brubeck would have been 37 when this was recorded. This album is so special and neat because it is just Dave Brubeck on the piano. So it is really him that is at the forefront. His energy, his internal state of being deeply comes out on this album. And I chose this song because as I was listening to music for, you know, today, I heard it and I was struck by the intensity of love, the playfulness, the energy. And at one point, like, there's so much joy that comes out as he's playing on the piano. It's almost like he's like thundering on the keys, but in a good way. You can just feel this like deep, like, I'm just in this love. It's just like flowing out of me, and it is so infectious and lovely. And I just thought this is the song that we need for today. As I started out in the beginning of this video, I was really thinking about how we as humanity need to have more love and tolerance for one another on an international level, like, you know, the war between Israel and Hamas. In the United States, things are incredibly polarized politically as well, between Republicans and Democrats, red and blue. And we need to have more love and acceptance of our differences with one another. Sometimes, you know, on a personal level, that can trickle down to, like, our partnerships, you know, our friendships even. And this song is such a beautiful way to kind of reaffirm and just commit yourself to coming from a place of love. This song is saying, yes, in a romantic partnership, I'm committed to you. I will be with you. Our love will endure. And there's also just this message of the fact that this things cannot be any other way. We have got to be remain and committed to coming and abiding in a deep place of love, because if we don't, things will be dire, as we are seeing what is happening between Israel and Hamas, the polarization in the United States. If we don't have this deep love, there is just the erosion of peace, hope, and joy. So as you're listening to this song, I want to invite you to just soak up the spirit of the song and maybe reflect on ways in your life where you could be more loving or open-hearted, or areas where you would like to be more loving or open-hearted. Or you might even think about, you know, a friend, a partner, a parent, whatnot, your child, and want to go share the deep love that you have with them. So for this reason, I would put this song into the category of emotional dwelling, which today for me, I want to come from a very open-hearted and loving place. So give the song a listen. Let me know what you think, what category you would put into, what thoughts, feelings, and reflections came up. I would love to hear from you. Happy birthday again to Dave Brubeck in heaven. May jazz therapy soothe your soul. Thank you so much for being with me today.